Hello, everyone, and happy Ayurveda Day. On this auspicious occasion, we are bringing you another learning session on home remedies for digestive system as per Ayurveda. Presenting this topic, we have Dr. Usha Devki, who is MD in Ayurveda. Dr. Usha has been a professor as well as a practitioner for the last 12 years with specialization in Ayurveda drug manufacturing. I am Amita from Nourish Talk, a global platform for natural and holistic therapies. I'd like to introduce all of you to Vaidya Usha Devki, who's joining us from India right now. Namaste and welcome, Dr. Usha. Hello, Dr. Usha, can you hear me? Dr. Usha, can you hear me?
Can you hear me?
Yes. Can we get started now?
Yeah, sure, we can.
Dr. Usha, we cannot hear you.
Greetings of Dhanvantari Day, Dhanvantari Jayanti. That I hope Lord Dhanvantari blesses all and keeps you healthy. Oh, can we go to previous slide, Amita?
First your background? Slide. Yes.
Next slide.
Okay. Yes, to Dr. Usha,
as all of us know, Ayurveda, all which helps and guide, lead. Yes.
Your voice is breaking up. Please, can you? Your voice is not clear. Can you? Dr. Usha, your voice is breaking up. It's not clear.
Hello.
I cannot hear you. We cannot hear you.
Okay. May I get the first slide?
No, it is on the first slide. You can start now. Can you get started? We are on the first slide.
Yeah, so
Dr. Usha, we are on the first slide. Can you get started?
Yeah, we can get next slide. Please.
No, we haven't covered the first slide. So can you start from the beginning? Because we didn't hear anything you said.
So that's in the next slide. How the life to be.
Dr. Usha, we did not hear anything at all, but you said your voice is not audible at all. You have to start from the introduction and brief background from the beginning. Your voice is not clear.
Knowledge which has run from the 5,000 relations in our life, which we have to follow physically, emotionally, spiritually, socially. To attain a purushartha, that is, therefore, purusharthas. So,
Dr. Usha, your voice is not audible to anyone. You have to start from the beginning.
Ayurveda, the diseases that which Ayurveda is responsible, and for this purpose. Avoiding the causative factors, is it?
Dr. Yes. Usha? Dr. Usha, can you hear me?
Yeah, I can hear you.
We cannot, what you said is nothing is clear. You have to start from the beginning. So you have, your voice is not coming clear. So we did not hear anything, what you said. You have to start from the beginning, please.
Can we go to the next slide?
No. We cannot. We did not hear anything. You have to start from the beginning. I cannot go to the next slide.
Yeah, okay. I'll start from the beginning. Yeah, yes. Sure.
So I am in the first slide of content, introduction, brief background. So okay. Let's start at the beginning is what I'm saying. We did not hear anything. It was, your voice is not coming clear. If it's not clear, I'll have to cancel this webinar because we cannot have, you know, voice not clear.
Yeah. Okay. I'm just reconnecting my internet. Just a few moments. Okay, can you hear me now?
Yes, now it's fine.
Is that clear? My voice is clear?
Yes, it's okay. Clear. So you have to start from the beginning, from first slide that says content, introduction, brief background. We did not hear anything.
Yeah,
so.
I need the next slide for the introduction. Yeah, I need next slide for the introduction. Can you please move to next?
I have it. Yeah. I already have it.
So, my topic is actually I have taken the topic which is related to the digestive system, home remedies in relation to keep our digestive system healthy. I have covered few diseases which are very much seen in our daily lifestyle. That is ajirna, that is indigestion, anaha, flatulence, udarashula, that is abdominal colic or the pain what we get in our abdomen during digestion. Agnimandya, that is loss of appetite or we don't feel hungry. Arochaka, anorexia or altered taste, loss of taste. And amlapitta, hyperacidity. There are many other diseases which are related to GIT, but I haven't covered here in this section. The time may not permit. So, coming to the introduction with regard to Ayurveda, as all of us know, it's a life science which is based on the experimental science and it explains rules and regulations to lead a healthy life, which is not only physically, but emotionally, mentally, spiritually, and social well-being also. So these are the main aim of Ayurveda, which helps us to attain or to enjoy these purusharthas. They are dharma, artha, kama, and moksha. Moksha is salvation. Dharma means the moral conduct. Artha is the wealth. And kama is our desires. And finally, the moksha, the salvation. That is the final aim of Ayurveda. Ayurveda also emphasizes on to lead a healthy life, to be healthy. We need to avoid the causative factors which take us towards a disease that is called as Nidana Parivarjana. Avoiding the causative factors. This is the first rule in our life to stay healthy. Next slide, please. Can we go to next slide?
Yeah, I am on the next slide. Maybe you can turn off your video. It might be better.
Can you hear me?
Yes, we can hear you, but you can go to the next slide. That's fine.
Okay. Yeah. Oh, is my voice is break? Yeah, sure. Sure. So here, when we talking about Nidana Parivarjana and when we speaking about with regard to our healthy lifestyle, the first importance when we give to our Sharira, because Sharira is the
Dr. Usha, your voice is breaking up. I'm so sorry. We might have to reschedule this because this is just not working out. I see. Oh, okay. There are some, okay. Yes. I didn't know there were some issues with Zoom in general this morning. I didn't realize that. Thank you so much for bringing it out because I didn't realize. Yes, she is restarting. I don't know if you can be patient for her to start again. It's up to you, or I can reschedule it. Let's wait for one more minute. Let me know because I don't want. Dr. Usha, you had to.
Can you hear me? Yeah, I'm back. I'm back. Can you hear me?
Yes, we can hear you. Maybe you don't turn on your video so that the voice is a bit clear. So let's just hang on one second. So we start, I think everybody heard about this, the Nidana Parivarjana. Now we are going to talk about the ahara, how the food plays the important role. So let's go on the number three slide. Okay.
Sure. So as we know, Nidana Parivarjana is the main aim or main first step to be healthy, to avoiding the causative factors. Next, coming to our body, how to avoid these factors or how to make our body more healthier. In that context, the food plays important role of health of an individual. That is food mainly, which is processed in our digestive tract. For that purpose, I'm taking a background with regard to food. So here Ayurveda explains that na cha ahara samam kinchit bhaishajyam upalabhyate. There is no other medicine equivalent to a healthy or wholesome diet. There is no other medicine which is comparable to a wholesome diet. Then it also says that pathye sati gadarthasya kim aushadha nishevanam, pathye asati gadarthasya kim aushadha nishevanam. That means a person who consumes wholesome diet to his body nature, he don't have to bother about any other medications to cure the diseases. That means food itself plays a role of medicine. The food what we consume plays role of medicine in our life. Pathye asati gadarthasya, a person who is afflicted with any diseases, if he is not following wholesome diet, then there is no use of any medication in that person. So food is a prime importance which is given to maintain a healthy health of an individual. So that is always we have to be very choosy on opting and food. Just like a vehicle is there, the engines of vehicle has to run smoothly, the fuel has to be very pure and it has to be very good. In the same way, the food is a fuel to our body, our mind and our atma, and it has to be pure and wholesome to that body nature, that atma and that manas, only when the systems can work properly. So the fuel has to be pure and it has to be adjustable, economic, compatible to that body. Next slide, please. So here Ayurveda explains, Charaka, the Acharya Charaka says that Roga Sarvepi Mandagno Sutra Mudarani. So that means all the Roga, all the diseases in our Sharira, in our body is mainly because of Manda Agni. Agni is digestive power. So if the digestive power, if the digestive fuel is not sufficient to burn that food, burn that fuel, then that will be indigested, that is not digested, and that will give rise to many other systemic diseases in our body. That is why the digestive capacity of a person has to be maintained properly, maintained in a normal manner, and the food, the fuel which is given to that has to be in a proper way. What happens if we are not doing that? As we all of us know, Vata, Pitta and Kapha, the three doshas in our body, which is Ayurveda, is based on Vata, Pitta and Kapha. As we know, what happens when we are not taking proper food, proper diet, proper ahara, vihara, or normal routine and food to our body, what happens? The doshas will get aggravated. So there, in that case, he says that when he is explaining context of the roga, when we have to treat the dosha, chaye eva jayet dosha. When doshas are just to aggravate, they are just to vitiate, in that state itself, if you cure that problems, if you we cure that diseases, a person can stay healthy. If the doshas in our body, Vata, Pitta or Kapha, aggravates than normal, then it will be difficult for us to cure them. We have to take lots of, maybe like as Panchakarma is there, or many other medications, strong medications has to be taken, has to be consumed to cure the diseases. That is why it's said that chaye eva jayet rogan. When they are yet to vitiate, in that state itself, when we get the symptoms itself, we have to cure. So here in this context, I just want to say, just like how the home is first school of education, like we say mom is the first teacher, in the same way our health of an individual also starts from his home only. How we take our food, how we do our daily routine, this begins from home itself. Next slide, please. So gastrointestinal tract, as we all of us know, it starts from the mouth and ends in the anus, and it plays very important role in maintaining the homeostasis of an individual, maintain the balanced state of body of an individual. In Ayurveda, Annamaha Srotas, the food, the way the food is carried out, the channels where food is carried out, and Purishavaha Srotas, where the malas or the fecus is carried out. All these channels are compared, can be compared to the gastrointestinal tract, where the food is processed. This channel can be compared to gastrointestinal tract or digestive tract. Next slide. So some diseases as explained to in relation to digestive system in Ayurveda, like Agni Mandya, that is lower digestive capacity, Arochaka, altered taste, Chardi, vomiting, Atisara, loose stools or diarrhea, Pravahika, dysentery, Arshas, hemorrhoids, Anaha, distension of abdomen, Adhana, Atopa, Ajirana, all these diseases which comes under digestive system. Atopa is the gurgling sounds and distension of abdomen, Ajirana, indigestion, Visuchika, Alasaka and Vilambika, these are the types of indigestion where you have colicky pain. Udavarta, again distension of abdomen. Udhavata is upward movement of Vata dosha, that is gas in the abdomen. These disorders are commonly occurring due to weak digestive power, that is Manda Agni. Our digestive power is becoming lesser in capacity. Deepana Pachana and Vatanu Lomana and Shulhara, these are the first line of treatment for to cure the digestive system disorders. Deepana, carminative in nature, Pachana drugs which are digestive in nature, which have the quality of to digest the digestion, improve the digestive capacity. Vatanu Lomana, that is which normalizes the movement of Vata in our Sharira. Shulahara, Shulahara means which relieves the pain. And Virechaka. Virechaka means which loosens the stools and eliminates the doshas from the body to through stools. So these are the main type of drugs which are chosen for to cure the problems in our digestive system. Please next slide. So how digestive system gets upset? In Ayurveda, it's explained that incompatible and unwholesome diet. There are various types like Samashana, incompatible, that means two different qualities of drugs are mixed together. Opposite qualities ahara mixed together, that is samashana. Irregular food habits, vishamashana. Overeating, that is adhyashana. Before digestion of previous meal, we are taking another meal. That becomes adhyashana. Not at all eating or eating lesser than the requirement becomes anashana or pramitashana. Suppression of natural urges. This is very important. When we suppress, maybe in office or in crowded places, we suppress our urges like flatus or udgara, etc., hiccough, etc. So this also causes problems in our digestive system. Improper sleeping habits, late night awakening, extra sleeping, etc. also causes dosha variation and causes upset in our digestive system. Emotional disturbance is one of the very important factor which causes problems in our digestive system. And wrong daily routine, as explained in Ayurveda, these are the some reasons how our digestive system can get upset. Next slide. So as we said, in the beginning stage itself, we have to treat the disease. So from in the beginning, as a time being relief, so for that purpose, we can treat all these minor issues at our home itself, which are handy in our kitchen itself. So some drugs can be selected to cure some problems in our body. It's not only digestive system, it can be any system of our body. Okay, please next slide. So let us go for some of the diseases or problems and their remedies which are handy in our kitchen. First one is ajirna, indigestion or dyspepsia. What is ajirna? Anything when food is not digested, that is called as ajirna. It can also lead to some other symptoms like gas, belching, flatulence or upset of the stomach, pain in the stomach. These are the some symptoms of ajirna. So as we know, I'm not going in detail to the disease aspect. We are just taking the remedy aspect here. First remedy is very easy remedy and very most popularly used remedy. Fresh ginger and rock salt or jaggery. So for children who are not just, ginger is very spicy in nature. It has ushna virya, the potency is hot in nature. So in that, to compensate that, we can use jaggery. For adults, we can go for rock salt. So fresh ginger, maybe of an inch piece or 5 grams with rock salt a pinch, can be taken before meals, 5 to 10 minutes before meals. either juice can be taken or ginger can be chewed as it is. Has to be chewed and swallowed. This remedy helps to subside the dosha aggravation and it helps to improve the quality of Agni as ginger is having Deepana, Pachana, carminative and digestive capacity. Next remedy, little more soothing than the first one, that is pomegranate juice, black salt, roasted cumin, honey or rock sugar. Rock sugar is called as Khanda Sharkara in Sanskrit here, that is Sita. So here, this juice, black salt, roasted cumin powder and honey can be mixed together and it can be taken 15 minutes before meal. Can be taken some 20 to 30 ml can be taken. Next slide. Next, coriander seeds, fresh ginger and water. Coriander seeds, you can dry roast it or you can take as it is. If you dry roast it, that is well and good. Fresh ginger 5 grams, water 40 ml, boiled in lower flame or medium flame, reduced to half. What happens? The qualities of the drugs will be extracted to the water and this can be taken thrice daily or whenever required. As we are taking the remedies, all these drugs can be taken whenever it is required. Not necessarily only 3 times a day, 2 times a day. It's not so necessary as such. It can be taken whenever required or before meal. Thrice daily it can be taken, or in between the day of the mid of the day, if you feel ajirna, you feel your afternoon meal is not digested properly, you can take it 4 o'clock, 5 o'clock time also, no issue. So here coriander seeds, they are having again the qualities of Agni, increasing qualities, and they are Shita in nature. They are not so hot in nature. Even ginger is hot in nature. So coriander seed, what it does? It does helps to reduce the hotness of this ginger. And even a person who is having more of Pitta Guna, hot nature, can also go for this remedy. Next remedy is black pepper powder, cumin powder and honey. Mixture of these three drugs, 1 to 2 spoons thrice daily after the meals. As I said earlier, we can take when it is required. You can make a paste of that. We can even carry to office if it's required and can lick it like a, just can have it. This especially for the children, remedy 5. All other remedies can also be taken. Betel leaves is taken 5 to 6 number, black pepper 10 to 20 grams, and water 40 ml. They are boiled and reduced to half. And it's given to child 2 teaspoon after food. Don't give before food to the children. Can be given 2 teaspoon or 1 to 2 teaspoon after food. So all these remedies help to relieve the ajirna, as the drugs chosen here are of having the qualities to increase the digestion and digestive power. Next disease, next slide please. Anaha, flatulence, one of the very major issues everyone suffers during, maybe after food, when it is not digested, there is accumulation of gas in the abdomen. And it not only as a disease, it can be also a underlying symptom of various other diseases as such. It can occur. There are various types of distension of abdomen explained in Ayurveda. That is, retention of stool, often gas, is called as anaha. Distension of abdomen with gas, only with gas, is called as admana. Distension of abdomen with gurgling sounds is called as atopa. Distension of abdomen due to suppression of natural urges, especially the stools, the fecus, is called as udavarta. These are various types of flatulence explained in Ayurveda. So according to the condition, according to the necessity, we can choose the drugs. Next slide. First remedy, especially for anaha, carom seeds are the best drug of choice, because they are having Deepana Pachana Guna. Also, they are having Shulahara property. That means they reduce the pain and they reduce the Vata Dosha. Vata Kapha Shamaka. They balance Vata Dosha and Kapha Dosha. So, this Ajamoda or the carom seeds are the best drug of choice for flatulence. They are having special quality for Vata Shamaka, to cure the Vata Dosha. So Ajamoda Chubra fennel seeds also can be taken along with Ajamoda and hot water 30 ml. Just boil the water, add this water to the drug, keep it for 15 minutes as it is, and filter or strain it and drink after meals. This helps to improve the digestion, it facilitates the digestion and helps not to accumulate gas during digestion because of this Ajamoda. And fennel seeds also have the same property, but fennel seeds are lighter nature than that of Ajamoda. Next remedy is anise seeds and water. Same procedure. The water is boiled, it's brewed, the hot water is added to the seeds and strain and drunk. Whenever it is needed, we can just make like a green tea or a herbal tea. So these tea things, these will be helping us to relieve the gas or the distension of abdomen from the body. Even this Ajamoda, the carom seeds, we can keep it for overnight and we can distill it and we can store it. That's called as Ajamoda Arka. It is one part of, maybe if you're taking one part, 10 grams of Ajamoda, 18 part of water is added to that. We can soak it overnight and we can distill it through distillator. And this is called as Arka. This can be stored in a home and this can be taken 3 ml, 3 teaspoons. Whenever it's required, maximum for 3 to 4 times, maximum 4 times a day, can be just taken as it is. This also helps to relieve distension of abdomen. Next remedy is cumin seeds. Combination of cumin seeds, cardamom, camphor and sugar. We have to be careful. Camphor, be careful. See that, check the quality of the camphor before adding it. If you don't have camphor, you can just skip it off. So this is taken and it's powdered and kept stored in an airtight container. Whenever it is required, we can take it half to 1 teaspoon a day. It can be mixed with water, hot water, and it can be taken, or as it is, it can be taken. So cumin seeds, again, having the hot potency, it is laghu in nature, that is light for digestion, and it is kapha, vata, dosha balancing, and vata dosha balancing in nature. So it helps in treating all these kind of digestive disorders. Next slide. Garlic. Use of garlic in digestive system is one of the very highly practiced, even in the cuisines or any of the food processor. Processing garlic is in high use. This garlic has vata. It improves the strength of the neurons used in neurological disorders, and best vata shamaka, vata balancing drug. So this garlic pods are crushed, 5 gram, that is one part, to which 40 ml of milk is added, 40 ml of water is added. It is boiled and a decoction is prepared so that milk retains in the container. This can be taken before food or after food. Better to take after food because it may irritate your body sometimes, because garlic is highly ushna or the high potency in nature. So it can be taken after food who are having irritative stomach. So this easily removes the distension of abdomen. Buttermilk, garlic paste, hing or asafoetida, and rock salt. This is one of the very good combination for distension of abdomen, because buttermilk has rechaka guna. It helps to relieve, make vata to move its own direction. Garlic helps to relieve the prakupita vata, that means increased vata is balanced. Asafoetida also has this deepana pachan, that is carminative and digestive quality. It also helps to relieve the vata dosha. And saindhava lavana, Saindhava lavana also have digestive capacity. It relieves the vata dosha. And the person who is having distension of abdomen and who is having tendency to develop constipation also, that means hard stools, not able to pass the stools, such person also can go for this remedy, because this helps to relieve the constipation also, as well as distension of abdomen. And who is having any allergic to buttermilk, any sensitivity, they can go for other products also, but this can be given for children also. So these are mixed well and drunk whenever needed, not more than 3 times a day. You can take 50 to 60 ml at a time, can be taken. Next slide.
We'll come to the questions after she finishes. I don't want to, so some people are asking questions. We'll come mm-hmm. to the questions when she finishes. So I just wanted to let you know. Okay. Sure. All right. Please finish your thing. Yes.
Next is Udarashula, that is abdominal colic. So this can happen because of the visiation of vata in the abdomen during digestion. It can be subacute conditions, probing type of pain, stabbing type of pain in abdomen during the digestion. Ayurveda explains that as various types of shula, udara shula, maybe a kind of parinama shula or anadrava shula. There are various types of shula in our body. Why it happens? It happens due to overexertion, late night working or less sleep, and we are having heavy diet. Incompatible food habits also causes udara shula or abdominal pain during digestion. Irregular food habits, habit to starve. One of the tendency of this generation is habit to starve. This causes pain, abdominal pain, and frequent consumption of cold and stored food items and mixing up of cold and hot items. Such habits of any individual may cause udara shula or the abdominal spasms. Next slide. So to relieve this, the drug of choice is hing, that is asafoetida. This is one of the very good drug which is having good Vedana Sthapana Guna. That means pain relieving capacity. So here this is one of the very good method. External application of hing or asafoetida is taken one pinch. Hot warm water or warm ghee. So this hing can be mixed in warm water or warm ghee. 3 to 5 ml mixed well, and it has to be massaged in circular motions in and around the umbilicus, all over the abdomen. In circular motion, it can be massaged. In 5 to 10 minutes, this abdominal colic will be relieved, which happens due to digestion. All these problems, what I'm explaining, is only because of the improper food habits and improper digestion. I'm not explaining or taking any details with regard to systemic problems. Okay, any systemic problems has to be consulted to a registered medical practitioner only. Don't try these home remedies. These are only for mild symptoms of digestive improper food habits and which leads to digestive system problems. Next remedy is internal consumption of hing, that is asafoetida 2 grams, rock salt and buttermilk combination. So we can go for the external massage also. Along with that, when we take this remedy, hing, rock salt and buttermilk mixed well, and it can be drunk 60 ml to 80 ml, can be taken at a time, maybe once or twice a day, whenever it is required. When you have pain, cramps in your abdomen, so this can be taken and you can even massage your abdomen. This helps to relieve your pain or shula. Next remedy, if you are not able to take buttermilk, if you have ajamoda or carom seed churna, you can carry it to your office also. Take that powder, carom seeds powder 5 grams, take warm water or hot water 80 ml. Even you can mix the powder. If you are at home, you can boil and reduce to half. Whenever it is required, you can have it. You can even add a spoon of pure ghee also to this remedy, which helps to lubricate your intestine also, internal channels. Without ghee also, it can be taken. Next slide. Combination of asafoetida, rock salt, carom seeds and dry ginger. Powder are mixed and can be stored, and whenever it is required, it can be taken along with hot water. As I said earlier, if your body is of more dry in nature, we can add a spoon of ghee also into that. Don't add any oil. If you're adding any oil, it won't serve our purpose. Ghee is having a digestive, increases the digestive capacity. It's called as Deepana, and it is yoga vahi in nature. That means it admits other qualities of other drugs also into it, and it enhances its own quality. So only ghee can be added if it is required. Otherwise, we can take just as it is, hing, rock salt, carom seeds and dry ginger powder and stored. Next remedy is having who is of more of hot in nature, we can add combination of cardamom powder, cumin powder, cloves and dry ginger. Dry ginger has a guna of even who is having more tending to have loose stools. In such person who is having abdominal cramps, and in such person dry ginger can be adopted because it is having guna of sangrahi. It absorbs the excess moisture from your intestine. Dry ginger, not the fresh ginger. So this combination can be taken half teaspoon whenever required or thrice daily. So whenever required does not mean that you can take 5 to 6 times a day. It is only maximum 3 times a day, but when required doesn't, it's not in relation with when you take your food, 3-time meal, 4-time meal, not related with your food. When you have your problem, you can have this medicine, but maximum for 3 times a day. Next slide. Next is Agnimandya, loss of appetite, decreased hunger in a person that happens because of the hampered or lowered digestion, digestive power, that what we call as Agni in Ayurveda. There is various 13 types of Agni. One of that, the first one, the prime one is being Pachaka Agni, that is digestive power, which is located in our stomach and in, intestinal part. Next comes the Dhatu Agni, which converts the nutrition, whatever the digestive things, into a nutrition, and it helps to circulate to our body. Next comes the Bhuta Agni, that means which gives the nourishment to the Bhutas, Panchamaha Bhutas also. So these are the types of Agni in the tissue level and in digestive level. So Pachaka Agni, when decreases in the digestive level, that causes Agnimandya. So this Agnimandya and Ajirna are the prime reasons for any other problems in our digestive system. The main remedy or the best remedy for Agnimandya, that is loss of appetite, loss of hunger, is to fast, or is to take limited food or light food items. When we see that whenever we have any Ajirna or any indigestion or Agnimandya, when we are taking light food items, doesn't mean that we are taking fresh salads. We have to only take cooked food items or steamed food items. Don't take raw food items because they are heavy for digestion. So langhana, langhana means fasting, or ekakala bhojana, one time food in a day. Okay, this can be adopted so that digestive, our digestive capacity gets some rest from its work, so that it can rebuild its capacity. That is the main thing. Next, just drink a glass of hot water for every 1 hour or 2 hour. We can carry a flask and take hot water. That helps to rebuild the digestive capacity and digest all the ama or the toxic collections in our digestive system. This is the best remedy for indigestion. When we get up in the morning, sometimes we feel maybe we take a heavy food at the night, and when we get up in the morning, we don't feel hungry. We feel just like heaviness in the stomach, and we feel the food in the last night is not digested. In that case, we can just take a nap for next 30 minutes or so, so that the food gets time to digestion. Or else, if you don't have time, we can just get up, take a hot glass of hot, take a spoon of jeera, that is cumin seeds, and take a glass of water and boil them. Just boil them for 2 to 3 minutes. Add a spoon of ghee, and you can just drink it in the early morning, empty stomach. What it does? It helps to digest the left out food particles and helps to even easy movement of vata in the body. Don't take any food for 30 minutes. Later, you can just start your daily routine. This remedy helps very good for Agnimandya, who in the maybe any time of the day, but better in the morning hours, who is having Ajirna in the morning time. The last night food is not digested. I haven't included that. I just remember when I just said, so please remember this. Next remedy is hing, that is asafoetida, rock salt, crushed fresh ginger and buttermilk combination, can be taken before food twice daily. 3 grams of asafoetida, 1 pinch of rock salt for the taste, crushed ginger and buttermilk 60 ml. 60 ml of buttermilk can be taken any time of the day. This also helps to increase or to rebuild the digestive capacity. Next slide. Next remedy, 1 gram maricha, that is black pepper, 1 gram powder is taken, salt, a pinch is taken, and this is kept inside the nimbu. Nimbu is made into lemon, lemon fruit. Lemon is made into half, and it's in put inside that, filled inside that lemon, and this can be heated. And the juice of such lemon can be licked in between the food. You take food, you just lick the lemon juice, and you have your next session of food, you can just lick this juice, and this helps to improve your digestion. Next remedy what we give, can see is carom seeds powder and hot water tea, that is carom seed herbal tea, what we can call, 30 minutes before the food helps your digestion capacity, and whatever the food you will be taking will be easily digested. The people who are having a lesser capacity, that means body is very sensitive, you can go for cinnamon powder and carom seed powder combination. These powders can be mixed together and kept airtight 5 to 6 times, maybe half to 1 teaspoon can be taken with hot water. One more remedy which we can even keep make into a powder and we can store in our home is combination of pipali, maricha and shunti, that is long pepper, black pepper and dry ginger. Long pepper, black pepper, dry ginger and cumins. There are two types of cumins, white cumin, that is normal one, what we usually use in our kitchen, and black type of cumin. Then sandha lavana, that is rock salt, and asafoetida, equal quantity, that is 1 teaspoon each. Mix them together, powder them together and mix them together and keep it airtight. This 1 teaspoon along with ghee, pure ghee, can be taken along with first morsel of a meal. Okay, I'll repeat again. Black pepper, long pepper, dry ginger, white cumin, black cumin seeds, then asafoetida and rock salt. Combination of these drugs, powder, keep it airtight, and this powder 1 teaspoon along with 1 teaspoon of ghee is mixed with first morsel of food and it can be taken. Usually in India we take rice. Rice is our food, main food. So we will mix it with rice and we can have it in India. In other parts of the world, whatever your main food, you can just mix it with your first bolus of your food and you can have it. Maybe it may be your bread or any other food items. Or you can just have as it is along with the ghee just before you start your main meal. This also helps to relieve your indigestion, to relieve your loss of appetite, increases the taste and relieves the flatulence. Next slide. Next is arochaka, that is anorexia. I'm not speaking about the neurological anorexia here. I'm just speaking about the anorexia which happens because of the indigestion. Okay. So it is a condition which happens because of the loss of taste, happens because of the imbalance of the three doshas. It can happen due to stress or sedentary lifestyle or wrong eating habits. Any of such our habits may also lead to aruchi. Or it can be symptom of underlying diseases like jwara, that is fever or tuberculosis or acidity, hyperacidity or anemia. All these diseases may also have a symptom like that is arochaka. But in Ayurveda, it is again explained as a separate disease and mainly associated with food carrying channels, anamaha srotas and rasavaha srotas. Next slide. The best remedy and the first remedy for loss of taste or altered taste is gargling, that is gandusha. In Dinacharya, if we see in Ayurveda, it explains gandusha as our daily routine to scrape out all the vitiated doshas or the stick doshas from our oral cavity, oral hygiene part of daily routine, where gandusha is the must. So if you are having astringent taste in our mouth because of vata dosha vitiation, then black salt and water, warm water and black salt is added to that, mixed well, and gargling is to be done. We can hold it in our mouth for some time or we can just gargle it. So this is for astringent taste in our mouth, because black salt, salt is vata shamaka. It helps to scrape out the excess dosha from the oral cavity. If it is bitter taste happens because of the pitta dosha vitiation in our body. Arochaka, where bitter taste in mouth happens because of pitta dosha vitiation. In that condition, we have to take the drugs which are of pitta balancing in nature. That is, Indian gooseberry powder is one of the best pitta balancing drug, and it is rasayana also. And cardamom powder, again, that is pitta balancing drug. So the powder of Indian gooseberry, amalaki, amla, which is easily available in the market, and cardamom powder can be taken a pinch. Cardamom powder, don't take too much, take a pinch. Indian gooseberry powder can be taken 1 spoon. 1 teaspoon can be taken, mixed well with warm water, and gargling is to be done. sweet taste, if the person is having sweet taste in the mouth, bay leaves, dry ginger powder and pepper powder, all these are kapha shamaka. Kapha scraping nature is there, kapha balancing nature. So these drugs are taken. Even you can take a long pepper also, and gargling can be done with the water where these drugs are added. Next remedy is roasted coriander seeds, half spoon, and hot water whenever needed, because roasted coriander has the ruchya guna, that means which balances the taste. That quality is there for coriander. So that can be taken to relieve the arochaka or the altered taste. Next slide. Remedy 3, cardamom, black pepper, rock sugar. Combination of these, boil in water, filter, and half to one glass 3 to 4 times daily can be taken to relieve arochaka, because this arochaka happens because of our improper digestion. So cardamom, black pepper and raw sugar balances the dosha and helps to relieve the tastelessness. This may not happen in one time usage, maybe a day or 2 days weekend we may have to use this remedy. If within 2 days if the symptoms does not reduce, please go and consult a registered medical practitioner to check out what is the hiding problem. Next remedy what we can go for, this is a type of avaleha kalpana, or like a paste, semi-solid consistency. Ginger juice and jaggery, equal quantity is taken, 12 ml, 12 gram each. It is heated in lower flame till it thickens. Once it gets thickened, add 1 gram each of cardamom powder, clove, pepper powder, cumin powder. We can also add cinnamon powder, long pepper powder of your choice, and mix it well. Heat it and mix it well. After cooling, add 6 grams or 6 spoons of honey to that and mix it well. Okay, this becomes like a linctus, and this can be taken whenever it is necessary. Half to 1 spoon can be just taken. Just keep it in an oral cavity in your mouth and swallow very, very slowly. Okay, this will help. We can take it in a bottle container and we can carry it wherever it's necessary. And whenever it's needed, we can just lick it. Ginger juice 12 ml and jaggery, organic or good quality jaggery. Heat it in a low flame. Let it thicken. Once it thickens, boils and thickens, add powders of cardamom, clove, pepper, cumin. Even cinnamon can be added, 1 gram each. Fine powder it should be. We have to sieve that. After cooling, honey is added to that. Okay, this is a kind of avaleha kalpana in Ayurveda, linctus, and this can be taken. Next slide, please. Next, this is one of the very good remedy, the citron fruit. This is very good for arochaka or the vomiting, even vomiting during pregnancy. In such conditions, citron fruit, the formulations will help a lot. Citron fruit juice or paste, ginger, fresh ginger juice or paste, black pepper powder 1/2 teaspoon and rock salt 1/2 teaspoon. Mixed well together. Honey is added 2 to 4 teaspoons, and 5 to 6 times daily we can just take a pinch and we can just lick it whenever it is necessary. Or if you're taking 1-3 times after meals or so, we can take 1 teaspoon full 3 times a day. Or we can take the same thing in a divided dose also. This can be just prepared in home. If citron fruit is not available, you can just go for normal nimbu, normal lemon. Tamarind juice. Tamarind, I hope it's available in all other places also other than India. I'm not sure. But this is one of the very good remedy for altered taste or loss of taste. Jaggery, cinnamon powder a pinch, cardamom powder 1 pinch and pepper powder 1 pinch. Tamarind juice, that means tamarind fruit. Fresh fruits or stored fruit can be taken. It is soaked in water, cold water, squeezed well, and the juice is extracted. That is taken 30 ml. Jaggery quantity sufficient, that is for the sweetening. Then cinnamon powder 1 pinch, cardamom powder and pepper powder 1 pinch each. Mixed well, make like a juice or a sherbat, panaka what we call. And this can be taken 30 to 50 ml a day. drink or it can be hold in the mouth. This helps to relieve or the cure or balance our altered taste. This also helps to calm your pitta dosha. Soon after you come from hot sunny day, if you feel very exhausted and tired, you feel dizziness, your pitta is imbalanced, you feel very hot and tired, this juice will also help to relieve that exhaustion after hot sunny day. Next slide. Next is amla pitta, very haunting problem of this generation. So this happens, can happen because of the stress, because of irregular life habits, or mainly related to psychosomatic disorders. But we are seeing the remedies only for the improper digestion. We are not going for the psychosomatic disorder here. And what happens in amla pitta? The quantity of the pachaka pitta, that is gastric juice, is increased, and the quality of this digestive power is altered. Bitter taste, that is alkaline quality of pachaka pitta, is converted or changes into acidic in nature. That causes burning sensation, what we call as acid belch or heartburn. This condition arises due to fermentation, and this is termed as amla pitta. The pitta dosha in our body gets amlata, acidity, and that's called as amla pitta. Even the other reasons too are irregular intake of salty, spicy food items, tinned food items, suppression of natural urges, even taking of many medications like NSAIDs or antibiotics, steroids, etc. also may cause gastric belch, acidic belch. Next slide. The best drug which is easily available, which is a fruit, that is pomegranate. It can be taken as a fruit, as a whole fruit can be taken, or it can be even juice also can be taken. This relieves acid belch or the acid reflux very easily, and it is handy also, which can be used by everyone. Otherwise, we can also opt for Indian gooseberry, amlaki powder, which is easily relieves or balances the pitta dosha. And 3 to 5 grams of this Indian gooseberry powder, if fresh is available, juice can be taken. If you do, it's fresh Indian gooseberry, amla is not available, then dried Indian gooseberry is available, or the powders are also available. This churna can be taken, mixed with milk, and it can be taken twice daily. It also has many other properties. Rasayana guna is there for amalaki. It balances the three doshas. Coriander herbal tea is again one of the best medicine for amla pitta. It, because it is having sheeta guna, cold in potency, it relieves pitta dosha, because amla pitta is a disease which arises because of the pitta dosha vitiation. So coriander seeds, 4 grams or 4 teaspoons is taken. Then boiling water is added to that, infused for 1 hour, kept as it is for 1 hour. Later filter it and drink with sugar candy, that means sugar candy here, that is rock sugar, khanda sharkara, what we call, that is added to the taste, and then it is can be taken. There is one more preparation called as dhanyaka hima in Ayurveda, that is 1 gram of dhanyaka, that is coriander seeds, are taken. They are macerated well with the hand, that means they are crushed and macerated well, broken, then to which cold water is added, not hot water. Cold water is added, 6 parts of cold water is added, kept for overnight. Next morning, it is filtered and can be taken along with rock sugar to relieve the symptoms of acidity. This also helps. Next slide. Next remedy for vetiver grass root powder. Remedy with the help, because vetiver is having this very good coolant. It's having very good cooling nature. Vetiver grass root, 2 teaspoons. Long pepper root powder, 2 teaspoons. If long pepper root powder is not available, just skip it off. Only you can use vetiver grass root powder. Even you can use sandalwood, shweta chandana, what we call. That is also having coolant in nature. So that also can be taken. Then boiling water is added to this powder, left as it is for 10 minutes, filter it, add rock sugar, and you can drink it whenever necessary. 30 to 60 ml a quantity can be taken. Kokum also can be added to this. Kokum is very good pitta shamaka. That means it balances pitta dosha. It reduces heat from the body. So in that case, if kokum is available, that also can be taken. If it is not available, don't worry. You can just skip it off. Lukewarm milk after every 2 or 3 hours. Maybe for children, this will be more helpful who is having acid belch. So lukewarm milk. Please use cow's milk. Don't use buffalo milk. Whenever milk is said, please use cow's milk. If packet milk is available, which is of cow's milk, that also can be taken. Please, if buffalo milk is available, cow's is not available, please avoid milk. Cup of lukewarm milk after every 2 or 3 hours can be taken for acidity. Or 1 teaspoonful of ghee with warm milk also can be used. Next slide. Hence, the main line of treatment, because Agni or the digestion power is the main source of energy in our body, what we can say, because digest the food items in the Sharira and it passes that good part of the food items to our body to nourish our body, mind and Atma even. Ayurveda believes in Sharira, Manas and Atma as together. Okay, so to nourish all these three factors, entities in our life, so food plays a major role to balancing of our digestive system is very, very important to lead a healthy life. So that for that purpose, we have to maintain our digestion properly, for which carminative, that is deepana, pachana, digestive food items, vatanulomana, that means vata, balancing food items, and langhana. Langhana is only case of whenever we have indigestion, we have heaviness. In such cases, in between fasting, that is giving rest to our digestive system, is always helpful. So this is the first line of treatment. As Ayurveda explains, Traya Upasthamba, where Ahara is said first, Ahara, Nidra, Brahmacharya, where Ahara is said in the beginning itself as three main sub pillars of our life. Because Ahara here we can see it's given very much important, and this is processed in our digestive system, and hence we have to give prime importance to maintain our health by maintaining our digestion power. Next, following Pratyahara and Vihara, not only Ahara, our Vihara also plays a major role in maintaining our Tridosha. So that's all about this session now. If any doubts, any clarification, I'm free to answer.
Yeah, thank you. Thank you so much, Dr. Usha. I'm so glad that we made the internet work, because it was an excellent, excellent presentation.
Thank you.
From, so I think we have questions coming up. So I'm sure. Thank you so much for, for the questions, everyone. Mm-hmm. So let me just see. Okay. All right. So there are, we are over the time, but we have to take the questions. Okay. Because we will give about 5-10 minutes. Someone is saying, in what ways does improper sleep pattern, either sleeping or waking at different hours each night or not sleeping at all one night, affect the Agni? Mm-hmm. How may one address it?
Okay. Because as we know, any system or any, as I said, the vehicle or the engine, it needs rest, proper nest, rest for nourishing the system or to have a normal balanced dosha. What Nidra does, Nidra is very important factor in our daily routine. A proper rest to our body, mind is required to maintain the three doshas in our body. Nidra, when we say that, the sleep factor, if you are not sleeping properly, improper disturbed sleep and sleep which is less than requirement always causes rukshata, dryness in our body, and it vitiates or it increases vata dosha. Okay, it nidra, less nidra, decreased sleep increases vata dosha, causes dryness in our body. And when dryness happens, naturally when vata dosha is hampered, our digestion system hampers. Okay, our digestion process may get delayed. There may not be proper digestion in our body. And there may be even the udara shula, or they have improper movement of improper bowel movements in the body, which leading to improper digestion. This is how nidra, decreased nidra, causes the digestive problems. When we go for increased nidra, oversleeping vitiates kapha dosha. It increases, it causes kapha vriddhi, what we call it, causes kapha increases kapha. So when kapha is also increased, the digestion slows because of the guruta of the kapha. Kapha will block the channels of digestion and causes improper digestion. Ajirna may take place. This is how increased kapha causes improper digestion. Hence, nidra is an important factor to have a proper digestion in our body.
Okay, so we have two more questions. These are, by the way, this is an educational session. If you have serious issues, you must go to your practitioner. We wanted to do a home remedy, simple home remedy session. So this question is, does taking these remedies day after day only tend to the symptoms, or do these herbs and minerals functionally correct the underlying problem present? For example, if leaky gut lining is the issue, after a certain number of weeks or months of taking daily, does the lining heal, so to speak? So someone has a leaky gut syndrome and asking, can we do these remedies that you talked about, home remedies, does that help the healing of the lining, so to speak?
Okay, understood. But these remedies are just as a home remedy in the beginning session or the beginning stage of any problem, just improper digestion or improper daily habit which causes improper digestion. But any major issues, we have to consult the individual, whoever it is, have to consult the registered medical practitioner, take guidance, and of course they can continue the medicines or these remedies as per their guidance. If they okay, because patient has to be diagnosed properly, according to them, if this can be continued, they can take it daily basis, no problem, because they are, even they have nutritional value. They don't have only medicinal value or therapeutic value. These drugs what we have taken also have nutritional value too, so hence they can be used on daily basis. But for the problem, they have to consult the medical practitioner.
So she, the person is saying, not necessarily the gut lining, was just an example. That's what the person was saying. It was mainly trying to understand if these remedies just address symptoms or go further. So you answered that question.
If they are simple symptoms, just with these remedies, they will just get normal. Otherwise, if there are any underlying systemic problems, they may not get subsided by these home remedies. They have to consult the practitioner.
Yeah, depends on the gravity of your
within so one day or 2 days, these are only up to the relieving of the symptoms. Within 1 or 2 days, if the symptoms doesn't get relieved, they have to consult the practitioner.
So then another question is, it's understandable that these remedies are not like pharmaceuticals, which we talked about, which may cause dependency with withdrawals if the body does not receive them daily. Okay, but could it be possible that these foods and mineral remedies taken daily to respond to a symptom may cause a similar body dependency, where the body expects help and becomes less naturally able at doing the necessary action on its own without natural foods help? I thought they were all natural remedies.
Everything they are natural, and they don't cause any dependency as such, because they are not only having, as I said earlier, therapeutic value, they also have the food value. Hence, they can be continued on daily basis, or even these drugs can be used as a spices in your food item so that you don't get any problem as such.
So hope that answered your question. I think that all the things that she talked about were common kitchen items. At least most of the items, I think we use it. All of us use it. In our cooking or something or the other. So that was the intent. The intent is not to give any medical advice. The intent was to just give simple home remedies for simple digestive issues.
Yeah, I just want to say, whenever you take garlic or when you take any camphor or any such thing, the person who is having high blood pressure have to take care of, because they have the quality to decrease the BP, and who is having diabetic mellitus, they can also avoid the rock sugar and the honey as such. So according to your body type, you can choose the type of remedies whichever is opt for you.
Yes, absolutely. Any other comments or questions? Any other feedback, anything before I wrap up? I'm just going to wrap up this session. I just wanted to make sure that you take the questions. Okay. Well, thank you so much, Dr. Usha. I think it was an excellent session. It's too bad. Oh, now we can see you. That's great.
Because I thought internet is unstable, that will be a problematic. So it's better.
Yes. No, I think that was really a good choice. I think it was an excellent session for simple home remedies that all of us can do for simple digestive issues. You know, we will be launching a simple workshops also that would be a little bit more involved, 1.5 hour with Dr. Usha at the, you know, in the beginning of the year. So we will let everyone know. For now, happy Ayurveda Day. Thank you so much for listening to us. And please help us share. Yes, help us. And tomorrow is Diwali. Most of us know in the world what Diwali is. So happy Diwali to all
our viewers. Happy Diwali to all viewers. Stay healthy.
Thank you so much. Thank you, Dr. Usha, for being with us. Thank you.
Thank you.